Hi, today I'm going to be showing you what I'm using for the month of November on my skin, both face and body. Since it's cranberry month, cranberry sauce month, I'm going with the cranberry theme. And I have this soap from this company, this brand, Cranberry Apple. And I got these cranberry orange scrub and body butter from Spite Garden. Kind of a cool name. Smells amazing. Smells just like orange cranberry. I'm gonna be using that in the shower. And to wash my face, I'm trying out this Innisfree Volcanic Face Wash. So far I like it. It's a bit creamy, but I don't have any issues with that. Normally creamy products kind of feel a bit too much on my face, as if it's leaving kind of like oil film after I wash my face. This is working out fine for me. I just use it with a washcloth. And I'm also still using that High Bar Solid Shampoo, which surprisingly has lasted for maybe like 3 months already. That's amazing. So that's not shown right now, but you've seen it in other videos. And after the shower, I will use this deodorant. I've had this for a while, and it's kind of running low. It still kind of has that fruity theme, lemon-like, citrus sort of. So that's what I'm using for deodorant. And in terms of skincare, I'm using up this sample of Glow Recipe. It works okay. I don't know if I love it enough to buy it, but so far this is working okay for me. I haven't seen a huge difference in my skin, but it also hasn't had any bad effects or downsides for me so far. And I'm also going to be using these two. These are also samples that I didn't actually pay for. And I'll tell you how it goes for me. I'm still trying to figure out how to use this one. It seems like it's like a daytime product, but I'll figure it out. And on days when I'm not using that, I'm using up my pharmacy serum. This is pretty heavy duty. It does feel like it's doing a lot for my skin. Sometimes if I have a little cut or a little scrape, it kind of stings a bit. But yeah, it's okay, it's a bit expensive. I'm not going to buy it again once I finished it. Whenever I feel like I need a bit of moisture, I'm using my Ole Henriksen moisturizer. Probably going to be my last jar, this is getting harder to find. And, I also think that maybe I should just find something else. I kind of have a habit of trying to hold on to certain products, and it seems kind of pointless, because if it's no longer being made, it's just going to get harder and harder to track down, so I'll find something else. But yeah, this is my favorite moisturizer, and I have been using it for decades, actually, like over 10 years. And sadly, because they hate me, no they don't, they discontinued it. So, end of an era. I'm still working on my, amazingly, the avocado eye cream, which you can see is really dwindling. That's how far it's gone. I'm saving the pot for when it's done so I can squirt some of my other Glow Recipe guava eye cream into it. So, if that gets finished before the month ends, I'm switching over to these. This is okay. So far, I see no negative side effects. Still kind of working my way through it, trying to see what I think of it. It's like an okay, it's like a fine eye cream. It's okay. Nothing too amazing though. This one I like a lot better. It feels a lot richer to me. And I like the slim too, because you can put it in your purse if you have to go somewhere. Seems really nifty. And for after the shower, for the first time, I have a perfume oil roll-on. This is from Nest. And it's orange, Seville orange. I actually kind of like this because this is a lot better for when you're with someone who has like allergies to fragrance, and it doesn't so much like spritz everywhere like a spray. It's also very, very concentrated, so I'm really glad about the quality of this. I only have to run a little bit, and it feels like really nice to just wear it. And something else I'm using is hand cream, Benton's Shea Butter and Olive Hand Cream, and my old standby, the Misa Lip Balm, which I have two more tubes of that I haven't opened up yet, and that's how much I've used up. That's all that's left. I'm pretty sure this may finish before the month ends, and then I might just either open up a new tube of this or try a different lip balm. I'm also using this one. Focuses. Yep. Lip treatment balm, which is really rich and luxurious. But I don't feel as if it's as greasy as I want it to be. I like it a lot. This was from my April haul, which is on this channel. It's good. I'm still trying to decide if I like it a lot, so I can let you all know if you should buy it. So this has been working fine for me so far. I do wish the company would release more scented hand creams, but so far this is fine. The scent is a little bit too basic for me. It doesn't smell bad, it's just sort of doesn't smell that great either, in the sense that it's not a floral or a fruity scent. But it's fine. I noticed with different hand creams, they make my skin kind of peel, so I couldn't really use those. This one has been working for me so far. And I'll report back and let you know if there are any changes or if it mutates me or something. If you hear growling, you know that that's what happened. So that's it for today. Let me know in the comments what skincare you've been using this month.